Fadil, I mean, you've been here before. Last year, you've had a similar protest. What is the plan this year?
To do the same. We had a similar protest last year. Last year, many of the areas went violent, something that we cannot control because of the element in our area, the element that government allows to thrive. This year, we tried to have a peaceful one. We're trying our level best. We closed that road at 6 this morning, peacefully, with banners and placards. SAFs came, jumped out, provoked our people. Many of our people came home in an area as volatile as Parkour. I can tell you what happens now. And I'm against it, is that these people are going to protest in another way, a way I'm not in favor of.
And just talk us through to some of the issues that you want to highlight with this protest.
The issue that we want to highlight is landlessness, homelessness, unemployment, gangsterism, drugs. Last night, these people are telling me 50 shots were fired in Parkwood, not a single police van. Today, we want to protest peacefully. Look at that. The message is clear that we are not allowed to protest. You saw what happened in Bloemfontein and Wallacestein yesterday. Hardly any shots fired. I've been told that 4 of our members have been arrested already. Good evening, everyone. Monday, 27th, we will be shutting down the Cape Metro and other areas. We'll be shutting down because of the lack of opportunity for colored people. We will be shutting down because you're victimizing our teachers. We'll be shutting down because the RDP housing you're building. We'll be shutting down because you throw down a structure in Hout Bay and call it an illegal structure, but then you put up illegal ones in Manenberg. That's the city of Cape Town. We'll be shutting down because the ANC doesn't have the political will to combat gangsterism and drugs. We'll be shutting down because of colored marginalization. We'll be shutting down because we're letting you know that we have an identity and it is time we claim it. This is our stratcom. This is our people who've put the hours in to make sure that this thing is a success. We'll be shutting down because we don't want JP Smith to be our MACO member for safety and security. I don't know why he's still in the job. He should have been fired after what they did in Hout Bay. We want the petrol thief Branson to be gone with him. We'll be shutting down because the colored people say no. No more to victimization. No more to marginalization. We are full and active citizens of this country. We are the original owners of this province. You will learn on Monday. Thank you.
I'm coming to you from Mitchell's Plain this morning. It's a very bitterly cold morning here on the Cape Flats. I'm on the corner of AZ Berman and Highlands Drive, where a number of protesters had gathered. They'd been here since 4 o'clock this morning, most of them with banners. And when we speak to them, they're telling us that the reason they are here is because they are bemoaning what they call poor service delivery, especially to coloured communities across Cape Town. Now, quite a number of metro police, as well as traffic officials and a police presence behind me just now coming to warn those that had gathered here along the roadside at the corners of Highlands Drive and AZ Berman that they are indeed breaching the Disaster Management Act by gathering in this fashion. What has since happened is most of the protesters have now moved to the side of the road. I'm joined by one of them right now. Just very briefly, you told me just now that you've been here since early this morning. Similar protest action happening across Cape Town today. What exactly is your core message?
The core message to the people here is the colored people of South Africa, well, the Western Cape, we are hurtful of being marginalized, being mistreated, and being used as second-class citizens of the Western Cape and South Africa. We are not getting a fair or equal chance in everything we do, housing, employment. We are the people that is doing all the work, but we are the people that always has to get the second-class treatment, especially in the Western Cape, in the city. They don't care about us. Our people are dying like flies, but nobody cares about us. There's never been so much law enforcement and police in the Mitchells Plain as in today, and we're having a peaceful protest here.
I saw some interaction between yourself and a police officer just now. What exactly was that altercation about?
The police came here, a white gentleman approached me, and he said to me, you have 5 minutes to disperse, but in a very disrespectful way. Secondly, another police officer came to me, but a colored guy, and he said to me, please, sir, can I speak to you on one side, and he requested that I just move to the side. And I asked the guy, but why do you treat us this way? Why didn't you speak to me like a normal person? Why do you disrespect me like that? I am just doing a peaceful protest here because the people, or the colored people of the Western Cape, are tired of this treatment. Why are we treated like this? We want to know that.
What are you hoping to achieve with today's shutdown?
The objective of today's shutdown is to sit with the city and tell them, listen to us, give us an ear, be fair with us, listen to our grievances, our concerns. Why are our people always being marginalized by you? If you apply for a job, why can't you get a fair chance? You don't get a fair chance. You don't get fair housing. We still have people that's waiting for 50 years. They're waiting 50 years for a house. Imagine 50 years. They're probably going to die without a house. And nobody's supporting that. The city is not helping us in any way here. And we are heartful of that.
Thank you very much, sir.
You're welcome.
Sakina, so just there, just some of the issues being highlighted by one of the protesters, also a member of the Cape Palate Congress, telling us that the issue of poor service delivery, housing, unemployment, these are socioeconomic issues that are running rampant across most communities across the Cape Flats, and those are the issues that they want to have addressed, and the reason for this planned shutdown, which is taking place across various communities this morning. We understand that there have been some tyres set alight as well in Military Road, and that's in Steenberg. We also understand that there have been some road closures in the Eastern River area. We are definitely monitoring what's happening on the ground at the moment. The protest action here in Mitchell's Plain, at least, on the corner of AZ Berman and Highlands Drive, proceeding peacefully as we speak at this hour, Sakina.